Are you tired of spending hours brainstorming and crafting LinkedIn posts that will actually engage your audience? And don't even get me started with finding the right keywords to make your posts visible to the right people. It's an endless cycle of frustration and guesswork, right? But what if I told you there's a way to streamline this entire process to create compelling, keyword-optimized LinkedIn posts in no time? In today's video, I'm going to show you how to take SEMrush keyword data in combination with Perplexity AI and ChatGPT to effortlessly generate LinkedIn posts that are engaging that will get you noticed. My name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add time-saving automation to their business. Check out the description for links to subscribe to my newsletter, as well as links to the awesome no-code tools that I use in my freelance practice. Also, hit the thumbs up button and consider subscribing if you enjoy this kind of content. All right, so let's jump into how to build this automated system that'll create keyword-focused content for your LinkedIn profile. You can also use this to publish to other social media platforms as well. We're just going to focus on LinkedIn in this video. So I'm on an SEMrush trial account, and I have gone here and I have typed in make.com, and these are the keywords and the positions and the links for the top 10,000 or so keywords on make.com. I want to utilize these keywords for my LinkedIn posts so I get that kind of audience following me on LinkedIn that will come to me and ask me for help with make.com. And by the way, if you need help with make.com, just click the link in the description below and you can book a call directly with me and we will build your scenario just like this over a Zoom call. So here is the spreadsheet that I exported from SEMrush. You can see here we've got about 10,000 rows, 10,000 keywords here. And what we're going to do in this video is we're going to take these keywords and turn them into multiple LinkedIn posts. So this is our search. When we get done here, I'm going to mark this as done. That's what this column is. And here is our scenario or automation in a platform called make.com. Now, if you're not familiar with make.com, you can click the link in the description to sign up for a free account. You'll get a core account for free, which gives you 10,000 operations or 10,000 automated tasks for your first month. And that is more than you would get if you go sign up for the free account. So this is an automated scenario that is going to take our keywords and turn them into posts and publish them to Buffer. I like publishing to Buffer because it's kind of a buffer between this scenario and the real world. It gives me a chance to go look at those posts, make sure they look okay, add an image, and then Buffer will automatically schedule those and publish those to your feed on a schedule that you choose. All right, let's jump into our automated make.com scenario here. And you can see I've got a link right here. This is my trigger, and it's going to search for rows. And I'm running this once a day. I don't want to overwhelm Buffer or my account. And I'm searching for some keywords from the list in this Google Sheet that I've showed you. So what we're doing here is we are going to search for the LinkedIn row does not exist, means it's not been added to Buffer yet. And we're going to look for the keyword exists. So I'm going to put this down to one right now just for testing purposes. I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to hit save. I'm going to right click on this and say run this module only. And it gave us a keyword. So we got the first row here. And if we go back over here, you can see Gmail is that first row. So we've got the first row and the data associated with it. So one thing I'm going to do here, if you notice back here, we have Gmail, gmail.com. Down here we have GMAI, misspelled. So Gmail is actually in here multiple times, including the misspellings that people typically use when they go to the make.com site. So what I've done here is I've added a step here that says, I want you to take the provided text and determine if this is a misspelled word. And I tell it that it's an application, and we want to determine if this is the right name for the application. So if I hit OK here, if I right click and run this one and type GMALI, so I reverse the IL in Gmail and run this, what it's doing is it's outputting the word Gmail. It's saying, yeah, that's a misspelling for Gmail. We're going to correct that. What I'm doing is I don't want to do multiple posts on Gmail and gmail.com and Gmail misspelled. So I'm looking that up and I'm saying, does this already exist? And if it does, I'm just going to stop and not use it. So I don't want to use the misspellings of Gmail or telecom or whatever it is. I want to use the proper spellings once to create my posts. I have a filter here that says if it finds it already, if we've already used it, then just ignore it and don't continue. Next, we're going to get into the AI steps that are going to help us expand on this and write our post. So you can see here, I've got a research ideas and keywords, and I've got a system output here that's going to tell it to give us a semantic keyword or an SEO keyword with an idea text for this keyword. And down here is our prompt. You're an automation use case specialist finding examples of how business owners can automate their enterprises using make.com. And I have our keyword in here. So in this case, it'll be Gmail. And then I'm telling it I wanted to do research and find semantic keywords related to Gmail. So this is actually going to output multiple things. So let's hit OK here and let's just test this to show you how it's going to work. So I'm going to say Gmail, that's in both places, and hit OK. And so our output here is in JSON, which we're going to use to parse. We're going to parse that in our next step. And so it came up with two. It said Gmail email automation and Gmail automation for beginners. So those are decent keywords we could use to generate a post. And then it's got some text here, a nice idea that goes along with that. This step is actually going to parse that JSON so we can separate those out into multiple bundles. Now we're going to do some research here. And what I've said is, please research the results using the URL and the keyword provided. Output verbose research with several paragraphs and ideas around this topic. So I've used the make pages. I've used the URL. So right here, I'm going to say for Gmail, I want you to use this URL perplexity and go research this topic. So I've given it the URL, given it the keyword. I said, please build upon this keyword from our perplexity and please build upon this idea. So I'm giving it content and I'm cutting it loose to go crazy and research this topic with the information we've given it. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to ask ChatGPT to create a LinkedIn post. Now I'm using a LinkedIn assistant here. This is where I can call ChatGPT and I already have a pre-configured prompt. That prompt came from a community that I'm a part of that is an AI community that uses Make. If you are interested in that community, click the link in the description and you can go join that community and get this prompt as well as many other prompts for automating AI with make.com. What I've got here is I've got my assistant with my prompt already set up with ChatGPT. I'm giving it the information. I'm saying, here's the semantic keyword. Here is the text for the post. Again, this post is coming from that research. We gave Perplexity all of this information and a URL, and it's going to go do some research to bring that back. We're using that for our post. This LinkedIn assistant will output a LinkedIn post that we are going to send to Buffer. So next we're going to go here and I've got the text of this, which will be right here, mapped over here. I'm going to send this to LinkedIn and I'm going to add the update to the end of the queue. I want to have enough time to go look at this and add an image before it gets published. And you're saying, why are you doing that manually, Andy? That's because I have yet to find AI images that really look great and don't look like AI images. So I like to add images myself to the post and I use a platform called Deposit Photos. I can grab an image that I like and put it right on top of that post. The next thing we're going to do here is I'm going to send myself an email saying, hey, you've got something to look at in Buffer when this runs. So I'm simply just sending the link to the app to buffer in an email to myself. Let's run this and let's see this in action. And then this step right here is going to say this is done. And that way it's not going to run the same one over and over again in my posts. Okay, so I've got this set to grab one keyword. We're going to hit run here and let this go through the actions. So I've checked for spelling here. It found that it's Gmail. It did not find that we've used it already. So it's researching the ideas. And let's take a look at the output here. And it found, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this found 6 semantic keyword ideas. So what that means is we're actually going to output 6 different posts from this one keyword. So this is going to multiply our posts with the way we've done this. And so we've got some keywords here. All right. They've been parsed here. We've got 6 bundles. Perplexity AI is doing the research on the second one now. All right. So we got an error on this. Maximum execution and overlay timeout has elapsed. So I am going to put a little timer over here. Going to add a module here. We're going to search for tools and sleep. And I'm going to put a 60-second timer here. So when this runs, it'll space out and won't hit this timeout. That's okay. We've got some posts here we can go look at. And let's go over to buffer. All right, this one was already there. We're going to scroll down to here and take a look at this post. Now, there's something here that I need to fix. I can see right away. I have these double stars here, which is called markdown, and it's meant to say that that is bold, but we can't bold anything in LinkedIn. And then I would probably add an image manually. This is the preview of what it'll look like when it is posted on LinkedIn. So I like what this has done. We're going to get rid of these double stars, and I'm going to show you how to do that. That's fairly easy. So over here on buffer, we're going to use a replace function. Replace, open parenthesis. We're going to paste the stars, and we want to replace that with nothing, with an empty string. So I'm going to go over here to the text. I'm going to click empty string and close the parenthesis. So now when this goes to buffer, anytime there's that double star trying to make it bold, it'll be removed. So I love this. I edited that post, took those stars out, and it is going to be ready to go once I add an image to that. I typically do that on the weekends, and I'll set up a full week's worth of posts and add images to those. Just a weekend task I do. One last thing I want to show you is the scheduling. You can get to that by clicking right here or by clicking on the clock. I'm going to run this every day at 7 a.m. and I can choose how many that will be generated right here. I would probably do one or two a day is fine, because these are going to turn into multiple posts. So I would probably just keep that at one and maybe just run that once a week. So we go over here and we can say days of the week, and we can say we want to run this on Saturday because I'll be scheduling things out for a week at 7 a.m. So in that case, this would have given me 6 posts that I could schedule out and add images to on a Saturday. Thanks for watching. If you want to watch another video about automating to LinkedIn, check out this video where I show you how to take an RSS feed, grab the content from that, and write it into a LinkedIn post automatically with ChatGPT. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.